If you're feeling isolated right now, it's not just you. We live in a super polarizing society, and we are physically isolated. But more than that, think of how our society functions. Most people now, it's just drive to work, you drive home. You drive to the grocery store, you drive home. We can go our entire lives without knowing our neighbors, without knowing anyone in our community. And then when we do go home to be with our family, we isolate ourselves. You know, we go on social media instead of interacting with our family. Instead of having a family dinner, we just get fast food, and then everyone goes into their separate room to eat their food. You spend all your time on social media seeing how happy everyone else is, and then someone turns on the news and you watch that to see how evil your neighbor is and how scary and dangerous the outside is. And then we just think about these things, these negative thoughts that are being put in our head, and we make everything worse in our head. So we think our neighbors are more evil than they actually are. We think outside is scarier than they actually are, and we become even more isolated. This system that we have has emerged out of good intentions and good innovations. Social media, technology, and the car were all supposed to be more freeing and make our life easier and give us more space. But think about what it has really done. What it has really done is separate us from our community, from God. It has made us separated and more isolated. Think about why we drive everywhere. Why don't we walk or bike places like they do in other countries? Because it's unpleasant, it's dangerous, and it's inconvenient. Because you're basically walking next to a mini highway. If you were to get mugged on the side of a road, no one's going to be able to stop and help you. You can be around so many people, but you're still alone. It's like social media. You know, you see all these people, but you're still alone. You're walking on the side of like a regular road. None of these cars are going to be able to stop because they're going so fast. It seems like there's all these people around you, but you're really alone. And even if you were going to walk somewhere, where are you going to walk? The grocery store? It's 40 miles away. Where are you going to walk? There's nowhere to walk. And that's why you have to drive everywhere. And we just think this is normal. This isn't normal. You think we either have to live in the skyscrapers, in the city, and then we can walk. Or we live in the suburb where we have to take our car. It doesn't have to be like this. In other places, like cities like Tokyo and Amsterdam, they're so bikeable, they're walkable. You can survive without a car there. Like if you live in Amsterdam, you aren't physically separated from your neighbors. You know, when you need to get groceries, it's not a big trip. You don't need to get in your car and go to the Costco and fill it all up and then, you know, go hide back in your house. You know, in Amsterdam or one of these more walkable cities, you just walk to the local grocery store. You know, and you see people that are part of your community on your walk. You see the grocery store clerk more regularly because you don't need to make these big trips. We are so car dependent. If you don't have a car, you're literally not a member of society. How are you gonna get to work? How are you gonna get groceries? And if you're poor, you're gonna get punished for it. What are you gonna do? Take the bus, even if there is one? Or you're gonna have to walk to it anyway. If you wanna walk or bike somewhere, you're gonna breathe in pollution and noise pollution. It's not a pleasant experience. Places where it's walkable, there's greater community, there's less isolation. If you get robbed, there's actually gonna be people around you who can stop. You actually know the people around you. Our urban planning emerged from a car-centered culture, but now we are seeing that this is bad for us. This is bad for the environment. When people have to drive more, spend more time in traffic, this causes more stress, this causes more anxiety, this causes physical isolation. If you wanna learn more about how unsustainable, unhealthy, and isolating our urban planning is, check out this channel. And he doesn't just complain, he actually has solutions and shows us alternatives to what we have. So not only is there that physical barrier of not living in a walkable society, but there's been a cultural barrier that has emerged because we have collectively stopped going to church as a culture. And one thing that church was a community center where you actually met the people that live around you, that have the same morals as you. And as we have stopped going to church, nothing has filled that void. You know, before I started going to church, you know, you see all these people and it's like they're NPCs. Like they're actually real people with their own lives, but we just see them when we're driving in our car, we see them in public. But when you have a community center like a church, you see people there, you get to know them, and then you see them at your job, and then you see them in public. And it's like, these are real people that live around us. The people around us are way more real than anything on social media. You may never even meet these people on social media, but the people around you, this is part of your community. If you see that homeless person, you know, we are isolated from them. We just drive in our car. Oh, we just kind of dehumanize them. But they're a person. They have a name. They have a story, and they're part of our community. You want to help your community. You want to volunteer, because these are the people that live around you. If the people who live around you are doing good, then you're doing good. I think religious people and non-religious people both see the value in having community centers. I mean, some atheists have even tried starting their own churches, because they want that. They want community. I mean, it makes sense that studies show that religious people are happier, more involved in their community, they vote more, they volunteer, because they are engaged in their community. But more than that, you can't just argue from a utilitarian point of view that, oh, we need to have these community centers because it's good for you. People don't live their lives based on logic. Do people read every scientific study and say, oh, I need to do this diet, I need to sleep this amount a day? Are people robots? Do they just follow whatever science says? No, we are emotional. We do things based on faith, what feels right for desire. And that's what church has. It has God that an atheist community center can never have. I really don't see an alternative to church and God. What atheists have tried to fill the void with isn't working. This community centers and humanism, it's not satisfying. Because people don't die for, oh, just be a nice person. What does that mean? No one cares about that. That doesn't inspire anyone. But you know what inspires people? Is God. It's not satisfying just to be a worker and a consumer who drives to work, you drive home, and then I'm a humanist, I go to my atheist community center because I read this study on it. That's not satisfying. Think of how we evolved. Did we evolve to stay in our home all day and to be isolated and to not have any community and to live in this car-centric society? No, we evolved to be very, very community-based. And that's why we feel so isolated, because we are isolated from people. And what does this lead people to? When you drive to work, you drive home. You don't know anyone around you, and you're constantly bombarded that your life sucks, that you're just stardust, that your life is meaningless, and then you watch the news, that other political party is evil, your neighbor is evil, you're separated and isolated from everyone in your society, and you're just constantly given fear. Oh, it's dangerous outside. Oh, that your neighbor, they're evil. Our brain runs wild. Luckily, there is hope. The cure to isolation is God and community. What I have done is I delete social media. I deleted Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, Facebook. I stopped watching the news. Stop watching this fake reality that's trying to scare you. After I deleted all social media, then I found a local Catholic church. Everyone has this thing called RCIA, where they like teach you about the faith. This is where you're gonna start learning about faith, and you're gonna meet people who actually live around you. It's gonna be so great. You're gonna feel so joyful because you're actually gonna know people and start having a community and not feel so isolated. And then you'll have this great community of people who actually live around you, and you'll realize that you never were alone. You have this community, and more than that, that God is always with us. Give RCIA a chance. Find a community. Realize you aren't alone. Advocate for a less car-centric society, because it is unsustainable, it ruins our quality of life, and it only further isolates us. I don't think there was a conscious effort to try and isolate us with the creation of social media and a car-dependent society. I think this emerged over time, but we're seeing that having this isolated society with no community is benefiting the people in charge. Because if you have a fractured society, it's easier to manipulate and control and get them to fight against each other. Overall, if you enjoyed the video, leave a like and leave a comment if you learned anything new and if you're gonna try anything new. I really, you know, getting a community has been the best thing for me, realizing that you aren't alone, because our society is literally so isolating. So I hope you give, you know, RCIA, find a community, find something. I mean, get off social media. Like, start living in the real world, and you'll stop feeling so isolated. Thank you.